Hello everybody, I'm Kai.
I'm Laura.
And our friend Paula's at the camera.
Hello.
We're all More Trees trainees and we're doing a series of seed collection videos for the Tree Council's Force for Nature campaign. Today we're going to be looking for hazelnuts.
And for that we've come to South Brent in Devon and we've come to this really nice woodland that was once planted by more trees. So we're going to go in there and see if we can find some hazel.
Before we start to collect some hazelnuts, let's find out what a hazel tree actually looks like. This is a hazel tree, or Corylus avellana, as it is in Latin. It has these straight, upright stems, and it's usually multi-stemmed because it's been historically coppiced, where it's cut and allowed to regrowth, because it has quite fast regrowth, and it creates these very useful straight stems. Most hazels you'll see are multi-stemmed because of this coppicing. Hazel coppice is particularly common as an understory in mixed deciduous woodland. Now, this hazel coppice is very beneficial for wildlife. Dormice in particular rely on hazel trees as their habitat. It's quite a small tree, up to about 12 meters, and its bark is this pale grey to pale brown. With age, it peels laterally. Its leaves are round to oval with a heart-shaped base and a pointed tip. It has this doubly serrated edge where there's these big serrations made up of all these little serrations. It also has a softly furry to the touch top of the leaf because it has these lots of little fine hairs. Now you might get a bit confused between a hazel leaf and an elm leaf. The growth form of the two trees are quite different, but the leaves do look quite similar. So a good way to tell them apart is that where hazel is softly furry, elm is quite coarsely furry, almost a bit like Velcro. And the base of the leaf isn't symmetrical with an elm. It will have one edge will be higher up this stem than another. And that's with all elms, that's a key distinguishing feature. Hazel is a monoecious tree, which means that it has male and female flowers on the same tree. The male flowers are called catkins, which hang down a bit like lamb's tails. The pollen from these catkins is dispersed by the wind and is picked up by the female flowers, which are tiny and they grow on the stem of the stems of the hazel. They almost look like red little buds, and that's the female flowers. And those red buds develop into the hazelnuts that we're going to be looking for today.
So this is how a hazelnut looks like. They normally grow by themselves or in groups of up to five. This is an example of how it would look like in a pair. And to look for them, it's better to look from the bottom up because they're normally just hiding underneath the leaves, like this one over here. Their color ranges from pale green to brown. They're pale green when they're not ripe and brown when they're ripe enough. And normally the best time to collect them is in September, October, directly from the tree when they're turning brown. Unfortunately, there's so many squirrels that I think they've eaten pretty much all of them, and we've got no choice but to pick them when they're still quite green. So what we'll do is just let them mature for a bit longer out of the tree and then hope that some of them germinate.
Here we've stumbled upon the remains of a squirrel feast. Look at all these hazelnuts that are on the floor. and almost all of them have these little squirrel bite marks and the nuts removed. So that's what we're racing against. There's still some here, but it's only late August and we're going to have to collect the hazelnuts a little bit before they're ready.
So these are all the hazelnuts we've managed to pick today. Unfortunately, it's not many. Like we said, it might be because of all the squirrels that have already eaten loads of them. But you know, we can just keep coming for walks and hope that we find a few more every time we go outside.
And who knows, you might get lucky and find an area with a few squirrels or with extra ripe hazelnuts. So keep your eye out.
But what we're gonna do now is just leave these in the bag in a cool, dry space and just let them sit there for a bit to see if they ripen a bit more, and then process them and stratify them.
Great, thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.
Bye! Before you go seed collecting, remember, try to pick your seeds locally or close to the area where you're going to be planting your trees.
Collect seeds from public spaces or ask for permission on private land.
Pick your seeds when they're ripe enough, but remember the wildlife is also on the hunt, so you have to be quick.
Pick more than enough for yourself, but leave more than you take for wildlife.
And finally, if you can, use a paper bag instead of a plastic bag.